Calendar applications come in many shapes and sizes, and the calendar market itself is getting rapidly faster in terms of where it's heading in the future. There's task management, there's even the ability to email inside of calendar apps, and they're becoming much more powerful. But today, we're going to dive into the best calendar applications on the market in 2024, and we're going to give and help you to find the perfect one for you. I'm very excited, so let's dive into this list of the best calendar apps. Hey everyone, my name is Francesco. If you are new here, hit subscribe. We're gonna dive into the calendar apps, with the first one being Fantastical. Now, Fantastical has been on the market for some time. Developed by a company called FlexiBits, it is a really brilliant all-rounder for those who have an Apple device. If you've got an iPhone, an iPad, or a Mac device, or even an Apple Watch, this is gonna work beautifully for you. It has a free plan. It also has a premium plan, which gives you access to more calendars. But for those who wanna get started with managing the calendar, using something like natural language input, which means you can tap away and write meeting with the Bob Tuesday at 4 p.m. and it will do all the work for you, and some light task management, this is gonna be one for you. It's beautifully designed as well, one of the best looking ones on the market. I recommend having a look at Fantastical if you are one that is using an Apple device. Next up, it was called Cron, it's called Notion Calendar now, and it is one of the better calendar apps on the market, if not one of the best in the top 12, which we've got today. Notion Calendar is free to use, and it doesn't mean you have to use it with Notion. You can connect it with Google Calendar and get going from there. It has some video conferencing functions, some scheduling functions which help you to book meetings, and now some more powerful ways to connect it to Notion databases and pages. And it is a beautiful looking application. Even if you've come from the Cron days, you'll know how beautiful it is, and it's really deep in that integration with Notion now that they are Notion Calendar. I'm a bit iffy on the logo, the new Notion Calendar one, but it works very, very well if you're looking for a simple, reliable calendar application. And it's available on the likes of Windows, Mac, web, and it does have an iOS application with an Android planned in the future as well. So number three is Morgan, and this one has been a rising star in the calendar space because it's really deepening integrations, focusing on artificial intelligence, and improving their task management in the application. This application is slowly turning towards being much more of a daily planner application, which combines calendar and tasks. But Morgan itself has a great free plan that gets you started planning your tasks, using time blocking and managing your schedule, even helping you to organize externally some of your meetings. The AI stuff is getting pretty interesting, much more accessible in the premium plans, which are a little bit steeper compared to some of the apps that I'll mention in this list, but well worth it because Morgan is available on a range of devices, including Linux as well. Number four is Amy Calendar. Now, this one only released a few days ago, and it is a bold statement to bring this into a top calendar apps feature already, but I am very impressed with this experience. Amy brings a really gorgeous experience that it was done in partnership with Open Purpose, which is one of my favorite design studios. And the application is beautifully designed. It's got a desktop web version, only on Mac at the moment, but they do plan adding Windows and Android. Android seems to be left out for a lot of people. But largely, this application helps you to manage your tasks and your calendar in one, but they have a whole host of integrations with the ability to connect with Notion, Linear, Todoist, TickTick, Things3, and even get your Spotify in there, which I actually think is a useless feature, but for those who like music, probably will love it. But largely, Amy has a beautiful mobile application, and much like Notion Calendar, and the mobile application is stunning for that as well, but Amy's one is really interactive and helps you to balance your tasks and your calendar in one experience on the go. So well worth checking out Amy. Again, premium is a little bit steeper, a bit like Morgan, but at the same time, a really well-rounded calendar experience. Number five is Vimcal, and this experience is much more for the advanced or professional user that wants to really take advantage of artificial intelligence. Vimcal is priced at $15 per month, very much like Morgan and likes of Amy, which is pretty in that realm of pricing. VimCal focuses much more on managing all of your events and being able to move them around your schedule that best suits your day ahead. Whilst it hasn't got any advanced task management, it does have some great AI features like Time Finder, which allows you to paste in all of the calendar links that you might have got sent by somebody else to plot that on your calendar to find which one works for you. And there's loads more AI advancements that allow you to get started. This application is also free on mobile if you don't want to pay the desktop version and you just want the mobile experience, but you're getting a watered down experience in comparison with some of the AI functions that you're going to get on desktop. Next up is Reclaim. Now, if you haven't heard of Reclaim, it is an application that really takes advantage of AI and also scheduling. It's much more of a team experience, so you're likely to bring in more people from your team to use Reclaim, a bit like Clockwise, which is another similar app on the market to this one. But Reclaim wants to help to organize your schedule automatically for you, moving around on the busy things that are in your calendar. And what's nice is you can add a bunch of your priorities or tasks, and it'll start to really put them into your calendar using deep work states to try and help you to get a period of time to finish those priorities in your day. And it helps to connect to other team members, which help you to do that a lot further. And Reclaim also has really nice features like habits, which allow you to plug in things like lunch, workouts, things that you don't want to move, and everything can be planned around it. And you can have all of these settings to make sure that you've got a little bit of a base of having a structure to your day, so it doesn't just go mental and reorganize everything. So that's a really nice experience. Again, very much more like a team experience, but one to check out if you're looking for really taking advantage of your calendar this year using AI. Number 7 is another new calendar application, probably one of the more fresher options on the market. It's called Hey Calendar, and it actually only is available with Hey Email. If you don't know what Hey Email is, you can find the link in the description and it'll deep dive into Hey Email a little bit more. But Hey Calendar is essentially a calendar experience that bolts onto your email in the Hey subscription, which is priced at a pretty steep $99 per year, but at the same time, it gives you email and calendar in one experience. Hey Calendar is gorgeous, works very well, and has a range of access on devices, which means you can get it on iOS and Android for on the go. And it really turns the calendar concept on its head with a horizontal day view and a way to manage your tracking of time and habits whilst in your calendar. A very impressive option and one to check out. Next up is Rise Calendar. And I love this calendar application. It's actually, I won't tell you, but it's actually the one I use at the moment. It is a really easy to use one. It's in public beta. It's only available on macOS at the moment, but it is really fast and really performs very well. It has a couple of features called Focus Guard and Flexible Times, which essentially block time in your calendar for you to actually get work done. A little bit like Reclaim to some extent, and some of the other ones in this list, it really wants you to help focus on your tasks. But it's beautifully designed, really easy to use, and I'm sure when they come out public beta, they have plans to add more. And if you want your team to go on it, you can get up to 5 team members, and then after that, you can use some of the more advanced one-to-one sharing functions and some of the meeting automatically with suggested times. That is a pro feature of that. Number 9 is Mayday. Now, Mayday wants to be your AI assistant to your calendar. So what it does is has something that, well, called Mayday, that goes in the corner and basically analyzes your calendar constantly, how you use it, what interactions you make on it, and it basically learns from that so that it repositions stuff as you do things, including tasks and calendar events. And you're probably wondering, that's freaky. But what it actually does, it learns from the best suggested times to move stuff a couple of inches each way, maybe even just 15 minutes each way. But it really does try to advance your learning. And they want to really grow that AI assistant aspect of Mayday. Now, it's only available on the Apple ecosystem at the moment, but I'm sure it's planned to come out in the future. And it's definitely one to look at because the experience, much like Rise and Amy, the performance is very, very fast. Number 10 is Calendars by Readle. This is a really nice application, much more simple than some of the options we've been talking about. The design is very basic, but allows you to really get started with managing your calendar. It's got something called habits in there, which means you can set and drag some routines into your system, which is really easy to do. And it's developed by a company called Readle, which develops Spark Mail, PDF Expert, and many more applications that are really well known in the productivity space. And I believe they've got 10 years experience in the market, aware and building really reliable applications. Number 11, it's Google Calendar. Google Calendar is free, reliable, and easy to use, and it works very well. If you've got Google Workspace, you can access a new Time Insights function, which gives you a breakdown of where you spend your time in the week. And you can even add tags to it so it learns from those even more. But Google Calendar, a real staple for many people that just want a free and easy one to get started. And finally on our list, number 12 is Moleskine Timepage. Now, if you don't know what Moleskine Timepage is, it's the most gorgeous calendar app on the market on iOS. It is beautifully designed and has a bunch of gestures, colors, and interactions in the app that are just absolutely fantastic. If you add an event, you can get things like what the weather's going to be like, when you need to put the umbrella up, and even the travel time to the event. But it really is really very nice and comes as part of the Moleskine suite, which has Moleskine Actions and Moleskine Flow as well as part of it. So it's well worth it if you're investing in high quality iOS applications, because Moleskine do them fantastic. Surprisingly, because they build notebooks themselves. Okay, so now we've dived into the best calendar apps. Which ones are right for you? Now, this is a little bit tricky, so we're going to really narrow this down to the best experience for different situations. So let's look at the best all-round calendar app. And I would say this goes to Morgan, primarily because Fantastio is only limited to Apple devices, but this is actually available on pretty much all of them. Morgan is beautifully designed and works really, really functionally, and it's really grown in my expectations in the last year. It's really shot up there, and I think it's done a very good job at being widely available and widely functional. Next up, best Apple users. I would say Fantastico is the all-round Apple user's experience and one that I think you should definitely try. Again, they've got great credibility and great reliability in the space for many, many years, and I expect them to make a Vision Pro app as well, if you need it. Okay, so best designed calendar application. This was a tricky one because a lot of them are really beautiful in this experience, but I'm going to give this to Notion Calendar. Really beautiful design, I've said that from the cron days, and their mobile app works very functional but very portable on the go. And best for iOS users, I would say Timepage is probably the best option here, well worth checking out if you're looking for a clean, beautiful calendar app. So that was the best calendar apps on the market in 2024. If you're in the hunt for any calendar apps, jump over to Tool Finder. We will happily help you find the best one and really pinpoint which one matters most for you. So I look forward to helping you find your best calendar application, and I look forward to seeing you in a future video. Cheerio, folks. Bye.